Where to begin with this one? So for months now, this seemed like a lock for Oklahoma. And I'm not even referring to the locks from, you know, the party at the palace, for you, if you know what I'm referring to. I'm talking about, this felt like a good thing for Oklahoma that we were going to get Anthony Evans. Just going back in time a couple weeks, all of a sudden, you have the Cale Gundy situation. We've been over that. And we have yet to feel any, after effects of that, if I may. And there was thoughts that maybe it could happen with a commit or two ago, or maybe it could happen with this one. And this was really leaning towards Georgia. And I normally, I never make videos of guys we don't get unless it's like I'm live or something and it's just a live reaction. But it's just nobody wants to hear bad news. No one wants to click on that unless your rivals want to come and see you get be upset. But I was mentally preparing myself as of yesterday to not get Anthony Evans. You know, four-star wide receiver, composite four-star. Dude has all the speed in the world. Just from what I understand, mom wants him home, closer to home. He's a Texas kid, so going to Georgia. But everything that's popping up recently is that with Cale gone and Washington taking over kind of wide receiver recruiting, Brent and Jeff Lebby took controls like, we got this. And they wouldn't give up. They wouldn't let go. And all throughout the week, you've been hearing, okay, Georgia's, we still, everyone's picking Georgia. Josh McQuiston at Scoop was just on the podcast the other day, said, I've canceled my trip to his high school game. He's going to Georgia. But Brent and Jeff Lebby kept fighting. And in the past, this is a guy you could, careful how I phrase this, but it feels like a guy you could let go. Okay, if you have to lose a wide receiver, okay, you can probably go out and get another one. Worst case scenario, you go in the portal. You may not want to go to the portal. There's no guarantees you're going to get a great high-level wide receiver. Today was crazy because there was talk about potentially Micah T's in-state recruit. Because initially they were trying to recruit him to play defensive back before and maybe play wide receiver now. That's out the window now as far as I'm concerned. Maybe not. But this Evans thing flipped back to OU only like 3 or so hours ago. As I'm recording this at 5:35 Eastern time, early in the evening. But here's what I take away from this. It's not just the fact that they got like a four-star wide receiver with all the speed in the world. And I'm going to make another commitment video tonight, by the way, because I'm not done today. The one I was like confident on, like 100%, along with everyone else, is happening later tonight. We'll talk about that one in a few hours when I upload that video, record that video. But I've made so many commitment videos since the end of June, and I keep getting, you know, surprised. I keep getting just blown away. And you're going to look at his rating, you're going to see, he's a mid-level four-star. Like, that's not the point. We're winning battles with high-caliber SEC teams, like, very regularly at this point. This one, we beat Georgia. They came on strong. Later tonight, we're going to beat Alabama for a much higher caliber player. And things are only going to get better, folks. We put a product on the field that matches the recruiting. Championships are in our future. You would think, like, what went down a couple weeks ago with the coaching staff would have, like, killed momentum. Brent wasn't going to have it. Brent was not going to let it happen. Jeff Lebby wasn't going to have it. And when you actually step back and look at things for a moment, it makes sense for a wide receiver to pick OU over Georgia. You're saying, well, Georgia's won the national championship. What are you talking about? If we're talking about how their offense goes, lately, historically, over the past 20 years, Georgia does not throw the football as much as you probably think they do. They just don't. They have not had a 3,000-yard passer since Aaron Murray about a decade ago. And before that, Matthew Stafford. Been a minute. OU, if you don't have a guy that goes passes for 3,000 yards, you're firing the coordinator. And based on what I think Lebby's going to do, like, trust me, we ain't going to stop playing offense in Oklahoma. So, because that thing popped up, like, it didn't make sense. Why would you go to Georgia? And, you know, I think I can say this now, but my guess is from what I understand, the pitch that Brent and Jeff is, look, if you commit to Georgia and you change your mind, we're not going to wait for you. If you want to jump on board, you got to jump on board now. This is it. Because we can go find someone else. We can go find someone to take your spot. Because that's what was bubbling up today. It's like, well, we're going to, because OU was prepared to go get someone else. Or there's Caden Green or whoever. Like, they were prepped. They got who they wanted. And this coaching staff, as of right now, has not taken any L's. You left Peyton Kirkland. Quiet, Texas fan. Nobody likes you. They don't take L's. His staff has not taken any L's lately. And it's just astounding to watch. By the end of tonight, there's a good chance that OU will not only be in the top five, they'll have a slim lead at number four in the composite rankings at 24/7. So, again, I'm excited. Because every time we build up to someone we think we're going to get or not get, as long as OU is still in the hunt, like legitimately in the hunt, there's some guys that went elsewhere, like Edric Hill and whatnot, and you know, there's some guys like Cam McDonald that they're not trending well, and that's fine. If you want to call those L's, I guess. But when it comes down to, like, we're waiting to see, OU's winning these ones, man. They're winning these battles. And I know, like, just watching high school football last night, we got to see Jackson Arnold play and, you know, Peyton Bowen and his little brother play and Yates play. And just you want to get all four of those guys if you can. And my confidence level is going up of getting those guys at this point. It's really going up. And I know people talk about them a lot and everyone's waiting. When is it going to happen? Is there a date? And I wish I could tell you more, but I think it's going to go into the season a little bit at this point. I could be dead wrong on that, but that's just the feeling I get. But even so, Brent puts a good product on the field. It's going to be an easy decision. And I think he's going to put a good product on the field this year. And when I do my prediction, probably early next week, and give you my take, which is not going to be too surprising if you've watched me for the past couple months, but OU football is here to stay. I mean, just everyone just waiting for OU to fade away and pick them to go 7-5, or we can't recruit without Lincoln Riley. And I've said this over and over again, but they fought for this one, folks. They fought hard, and they won. And Brent's a monster, man. He's a machine. And the SEC should be afraid of him. Because this is technically year one. I give him all credit in the world for what he did with this last class, because he salvaged it. We lost a bunch of key guys, and we were in the running for some pretty big five stars as well, on defense, no less. And we missed out on them because of what happened. But he salvaged a top 10 class. And he literally put this class all together by himself. Only one guy stuck around. An offensive lineman. A 3-star offensive lineman stuck around. He built this class. He, Lebby, and his entire staff. This is all Brent. Because I know, here's the thing. If OU has a really successful year, whether it's Big 12 Championship, NY6, or if they find a way to make the playoff, all of his detractors are going to say, well, that was Riley. Be prepared for that. That's coming if OU has a successful year. But we all know the truth. Regardless of how Brent's career ends up, when it comes to the record on the field, his record in recruiting right now is pretty awesome, and it's only going to get better, man. It's only going to get better. The cupboard is not going to be bare at OU with Brent Venables as the head coach. And very, very shortly, just a little over a week, we will find out what the product is going to look like on the football field, and I can't wait. So with that being said, I won't ramble on too much longer, and I've gone on 10 minutes, but I'll be back to talk to you again shortly later tonight. because we're about to get some really good news. Some top 100 player in the country good news. You'll have a good one, Boomer Sooner. I'm out.